Yes, everything that you're seeing is actually real. I know it doesn't look like it's real because of how they recorded it reality TV style. Everything looks fake, but I'm here to confirm that the deaths are real even though they look extremely fake. This is American Horror Story, you know, Roanoke, Season 6, Episode 7. My name's Romie, by the way. And the episode starts off with Sydney, again, is talking with his new, I guess, plus one. And the girl's just like, look, dude, I got you this food. Go and eat and enjoy. The cameraman's like, wait a minute. Yo, I asked for a salad. It's like, a salad? We're in the South. Just be thankful I found something green for you. Now, he puts down the camera, and I'm thinking, wait a minute, isn't it bad camera practices to walk in between the camera while it's on? Anyway, he's looking at the monitors and realizes, oh crap, what happened to Rory? Sydney's like, what are you talking about? It's like, rewind it. Rory's gone. Something just happened to Rory. And she's like, dude, I don't know. I don't see anything. Are you trying to mess with me? Yeah. And then while Sydney goes to try and see what happened, he hears a noise outside. And he checks on it, and it's the girl that just delivered them food, and she's dead. She is dead. She actually got sliced and diced. And guess by who? Agnes. Agnes the Butcher. That's what we're calling her. She's renamed as Agnes the Butcher because she's convinced that she's the Butcher. So we're going to call her the Butcher. Oh yeah, please like, comment, subscribe. And Agnes goes after the cameraman. She goes after Sydney. She's like, I am going to... And she's in there. She's like, that's all I hear when I hear her talk. Agnes is crazy. Agnes is cuckoo for Cocoa Puffs, and she's entertaining. I appreciate it. Audrey's going and looking through the house and trying to figure out where Rory is, and she's over it because, of course, they see murder in blood on the wall, and she's convinced. She's just like, you know, I can't find him anywhere. They're like, did you actually look under the covers, through the woods, in the closets, under the bed? It's like, oh, okay, I guess everyone's gonna go upstairs, and, you know, they're still... now recording, even though there's 75 cameras in the house. 75 cameras in the house, wow. They see blood, and I'm like, it should smell like iron. That should smell like real blood. Like, come on, why aren't you guys freaking out a little bit too much? The weird part to me was when I saw, when we saw Matt and Shelby and Dominic all kind of working together. That whole concept threw me off for a moment. But here's the thing. Audrey realized, oh, you know what? This is Sydney's fault. Sydney knows that Rory was trying to go and do the whole Brad Pitt movie. So this is Rory's way of getting out of recording with us. And it's pretty messed up. But, you know, she's... and it's funny because when she's saying, Rory, Rory, I'm like, that doesn't sound like a British accent. But okay, you're yelling. So I guess we'll give you, we'll let you slide on that. But she talks about how he's 15 years younger and the double standard of, since she's a woman and he's 15 years younger, it doesn't work out. But when it's a man, it's perfectly fine. You know what? I'm not going to say that's always the case, but you're not necessarily wrong. We have Agnes. She's contemplating like, oh my gosh, I just killed this girl and she has a child. And it's just like, no, but they all needed to die. They all were standing in the way. I just wanted to be on the show. I just wanted to be on the show so bad. Monette is talking with Dominic and, you know, she's drinking because she's like, this is some real BS. This is some bad juju. Dominic's like, you know, pass me that liquor. Lee comes in and says, Monette has a problem. You are not helping the situation, Dominic. You're not helping the situation. She's an actual alcoholic. Shelby, you know, Dominic wants to talk to Shelby, and this is where Shelby's just like, you know, I regret what happened. You know, that one weekend of fun and bliss, I wasn't worth it. See, I told you, it was a weekend. It wasn't a one time, a one situation weekend, meaning Friday, Saturday, Sunday. All 3 days with Dominic. So while she's trying to say, you know, Dominic, I'm not interested. I'm only here, like, basically get away from me. I'm here for Matt. Matt sees, he doesn't really hear it, but he sees how close Dominic and Shelby are because they're like this and this. So Matt's like, you know what? Dominic, you can have her. I don't want her. Go and F her on the table. Go and F her on the floor. I don't care. She's your B. Do whatever you want with her. That's how I feel about it. That's how I feel about it. He's just like, oh my gosh, this is crazy. I have to admit, it was funny. It was so funny. It was so funny. Watch. When Matt said that, because it's like, Matt. Dominic goes into the confessional, and this is where we see that Sydney actually gave him a small body cam, but he made a necklace. Because, you know, as we know, Dominic's only there to be the villain. Dominic Banks. He's only there to be the villain. And because of that, he's going to go and do whatever it takes. He's like, you know, I'm going to be the Omarosa of this show. It's going to be lit. I'm going to have $1 million opportunity. Shelby goes and sulks in her bedroom upstairs, not thinking that, yo, it's a blood moon. Agnes comes out and she has a cleaver and she's crying, and because Shelby notices that there's a bloody camera on her bed. So it's like, wait a minute, who came to the house? Why is someone else in here with us? What's really going on? Agnes gets her usual spiel of, you know what you did? I just wanted to be on the show. How dare you? You need to go. And then she slices Shelby. Shelby's like, oh my god. And then she brings out her phone and is like, I know I'm gonna die, so I want people to know who did it. All of a sudden, now I'm still trying to figure out who, what, where, when, and how Dominic came out of nowhere. But then again, I'm glad he did, because that was a big yell that Shelby exuded when she got sliced. So, he came and saved the day, and he knocked out Agnes, and then he got a towel to try and stop the bleeding for Shelby. He looked over, and Agnes was gone. Agnes went vamoose. Moet is over it. She's like, I need to get out of here. This is some other crazy-ish. This is a little bit too much. And they're now trying to devise a plan. You know, who's going to go and try to get out of the house to try to get to the producers, to get to Shelby, to Sydney, in order to actually escape this madness. You know, there's definitely something bad going on. So it's going to be Monette, Audrey, and Lee. They take the downstairs. And it looks like it's like Audrey notices someone. It's like, wait a minute, Rory, it's Rory. And I'm thinking, Lord Jesus, you see how he's walking? That's not Rory. I feel in my spirit, that's not Rory. Next thing we know, we see basically Edward, you know, like, ah! And, because Lee has her gun. Lee has her gun. She went bop, 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 four shots. And Edward went down. Edward came back up. And it was like, I'm thinking, wait a minute, is that really Edward? Just someone kind of looks like him, because Edward was one of the okay people, so why is he acting all crazy now? But anyway, that didn't work, so they ran outside, and they're trying to devise a plan, because they realize, we need to just make a beeline and run for it, because they're not safe in the woods. They notice that it's a blood moon, so we have to do whatever we can. Matt is trying to console Shelby, because of course, Shelby is needs help, and that's just saying how, you know, I have to apologize, because it really wasn't just you. Once we came to this house, I became a different person. And 2 years of dealing with the BS, it changed me. It changed me. It made me hard. It made me, you know, not open to the world. And I'm just so sorry that that happened. But I loved you at one time. Not anymore. I'm going to be here for you in general. But I can't go and promise you anything. Now, Lee, Audrey, and Monette, they make it to the trailer, and they notice, okay, the trailer's empty, what's going on? This is like the car, you know? So they see the bodies. They're like, it's like, I keep wanting to call him Shelby. And there was a crow picking at Sydney's intestines, so he was dead. He was dead. With him being dead, of course, the cameraman, the other woman as well. Lee's like, look, we need to go and get out of here. I'm going to go and pilfer. Oh, here's some keys. Start the car. I'm thinking that's a new Audi. 2016, 2017. Maybe 2015. Maybe. So you're telling me it doesn't have the feature where it automatically shuts off the power when the car hasn't been used for a while? I mean, new cars have that nowadays. My car. Anyway. So I know some reality random stuff that just irked me. And Monette's going off because she's like, why are we here? Audrey saying, you know, oh my goodness. You know, I'm not American. I'm not used to dealing with carnage on a daily basis. I'm like, no, she did not. she's right. But no, she did not. It was funny when Lee threw the keys at her to go and start the car, even though the car doesn't work. So they take a beeline, and while they're running in the woods, they see, oh, who are those people? Lee's like, you idiots! Weren't you on the show? You know what this is. Those are the Roanoke crew that are here to kill us. We need to go out and hide. You know, while Audrey's trying to say her goodbyes, her potential goodbyes to her man, Rory, she looks up, and because there's blood spatter on her. And she doesn't know that at first. I'm thinking, what the hell's wrong with her? How do you not feel that? Monette had to be the one to tell her, what is wrong with your face? Are you injured? She looks up and it's Rory. Oh my god! And she's down for the count. She's like, oh! Lee's like, what's wrong with you? Get up. We have to go. And Monette said, can't you give her a moment? Because, I mean, Rory's intestines are also hanging out. He's just dead. Dead, dead. And again, how it looks, it obviously looks like it's really staged. So, it's... Part of me is always like, dang, is any of this real? Is any of this real? And they're just trying to clown the main clown like Shelby. Is Shelby going to be the last person standing or something? Or Lee? I don't know. But yeah, it's definitely real because they put it out there that everyone will be slaughtered. Everyone will be slaughtered. Cast and crew will be slaughtered except for, well, by the time this is over, except for one. Something like that. Some foolishness like that. So, Lee was like, go, Monette, go ahead, go forward. I'm going to go and get Shelby. We're going to go and run. They go and run. They finally run. They finally think that they're potentially safe. Next thing they know, they see these spotlights. And I'm thinking, that definitely isn't going to be Matt or Dominic or Shelby. So, Audrey, Lee, and Monette, you guys better hide. They tried. They really tried to hide. But you know what ended up happening? It was the crew that made the deal with the Roanoke crew so that their family could be spared. And you know, the mother cannibal, they have their little farm. They're cuckoo for Cocoa Puffs. And they have cattle prods. So they were electrocuting them like... And while all that was going on, we see Agnes. Agnes is on her old... Oh, Jesus. Because I forgot to tell you, I forgot to mention that they saw Agnes in the woods. Monette and Lee and Audrey, and of course Lee shot Agnes. That was part of the reason why they were running like bad out of hell. And thankfully, Agnes actually survived, and she did this whole little speech and ritual to take the bullet out. And I'm thinking, Agnes, it's your time to go. It is your time to go. Like, this is a little bit too much now. This is your time to go. Can someone just snuff her? Matt wakes up, he walks downstairs, he walks downstairs into the cellar, Dominic follows him, and Dominic's like, what is that sound? Dominic knows what's going on, so he goes upstairs to be messy, to wake up Shelby, and I'm thinking, Shelby just got slashed in half, why, how is she possibly moving? See, this is the stupid stuff that I'm talking about. Are you trying to say she was so hysterical that she didn't feel pain? Apparently it was the witch that Matt was having sex with. Did it actually look like Gaga as the witch? Absolutely not. I don't know who that was supposed to be, but that didn't look like Gaga to me. Anyway, so Shelby gets the witch off of him, and then he was just like, oh my gosh, Shelby, what did you do? I told you I came back to the house for a reason. I didn't come back for you. I came back for her. I wanted her. I wanted the witch. I wanted the sorcerer. She was like, "Yoo!" And she took a crowbar, went to Matt's head, him in the back of the head, because she also did the witch. The witch disappeared, though. She kept hitting Matt. She kept hitting Matt in the head. Hit. Dead. Dominic had to stop her like, yo, you bugging. You bugging. What are you doing? You off to... I don't understand why. How is she possibly... Jesus. Then we went to Lee. Lee is going through it because, again, we have the cannibal crew going, and they have the cameras, so they know what's going on, and apparently they have TV, so they know why that they were going to be at the house. All of this was planned. They get Lee, they tie her up, they uncuff one of her legs so that they can go and rub this alcohol on her, and then also It looked like seasoning. I was like, why are they putting seasoning on her? Oh, Jesus, they're going to eat her. They're going to eat her. Next thing we know, they stab her. And she's like, aah! I was like, whoa. No, that just fried my vocals. I still have to do Queen Sugar. And let me calm down a little bit. Now, why was she... Dominic's was like, Shelby, you need to call the police. No, no, no. She's like, no. Oh my gosh, he's really dead. I can't believe he's really dead. You killed him. What do you mean you can't believe he's really dead? Forget this hysterical mess because you dropped that act really quickly when he told you that you had to take accountability for yourself. You see how all this works? As soon as you had to take accountability for yourself, that's when you decided, oh, I don't understand. Poor Kay, what are you talking about? Garbage, trash it. I really hope, if Shelby makes it to the end, I'm going to be pissed. I'm going to be pissed! He's like, there's cameras everywhere, boo-boo. You have to turn yourself in. You have no choice. And wait, what's that sound outside? Oh, God. Agnes. It's Agnes. While that's going on, we see Audrey apparently had cocaine. And so, the hillbillies are using up all her cocaine. And the mom comes through and says, you know what? Eat this. And they keep hitting them with the cattle prod. Eat it. Audrey is smart to realize, where's Lee? And they're just like, oh my God, this is Lee. It's like, well, you're going to eat Lee now, aren't you? And they did. I was so disgusted. I was like, Monette, you better not. I expect more from you, my black sister. And you better not. That's what I was thinking the whole time. Oh, wow. And like I said, Agnes was outside. Shelby and Dominic weren't sure what they're going to do, but they didn't have to do anything because Agnes, you know, she loves the butcher. The butcher, the real butcher, her idol came to pass. She was like, I'm sorry, I did it for a show. I know I'm a little crazy, but I love you so much. The butcher said, your services are no longer required. And slashed her right dead shit in the middle of her head. And that's how we ended it. I'm pleased. Please like, comment, subscribe. Let me know what you think. Come back next week.